Limited ad serving is a new Google Ads policy that Google has begun enforcing. And it's a somewhat confusing, unclear policy, ironically, because it's meant to try and prevent ads from confusing and being unclear to people seeing those ads. But hey, it is what it is. And so I'm going to explain as much information as I can about what it is, how it works, how you're notified if your account gets flagged for this, and what you can do about it. Hey, this is John from StubGroup. We are a top premier Google partner digital advertising agency. We are also the number one resource in the world for fixing Google suspensions and policy violations. And so we're always trying to stay on top of new Google policies and what this means for advertisers around the world. So let's dig into it. Limited ad serving. First of all, how do you know if you are flagged for this? Well, from what we've seen so far, Google generally sends both an email notification to the admins on the Google Ads account, as well as places an in-account notification in a red bar up at the top of the screen. So for the email, let me go ahead and show you an example of an email that one of our clients received who was flagged for this policy, so you know kind of what to look for. All right, so here's an example of an email that Google sent saying that certain impressions in Google Ads account, et cetera, have been impacted by limited ad serving. So they tell you, you know, the name of the account, or not the name, but the ID of the account. They mention, as stated in our advertising policies, Google Ads uses limited ad serving in the following scenarios, blah, blah, blah. And they say that they use both automated and human evaluation to help ensure that Google Ads follows these policies. Interestingly, in this case, they specifically said the violation was identified using automated means. In theory, that means that they would say it was identified using human means if that was the case. So this is a helpful piece of data to have. Generally, if it's being flagged by the automated system, it's more likely that Google got it wrong. If it was flagged by a human, they could still get it wrong, but it means that they probably put more thought into it, and so you might have a harder chance of appealing, but do with that what you will. And so they say, hey, if you believe there's been an error and that you haven't violated the policy, you can submit an appeal. And if you're in the EU, there's some additional redress options available as well. The limitation will remain unless you successfully appeal the decision. So I'll give you some thoughts about appealing it, whether or not you should or should not appeal it, so forth and so on. But first, let's dig more into the limited ad serving policy itself and just do another kind of walkthrough of exactly what that is and what Google has shared about it. So I'll pull up on my screen here the limited ad serving policy. I'm not going to read it through word by word. There's a lot of words here, but just kind of hit the high points and you can read it yourself. The high points are that Google is going to limit some advertisers from receiving impressions on their ads if they believe that there's a high likelihood that people seeing those ads are going to be confused about who is serving the ad. So for example, and the place I've seen this most commonly enforced so far is in situations where an advertiser is targeting brand keywords for another advertiser. So for example, the client in reference here, they're in the employment space, and so some of their keywords include the names of businesses where people might be seeking employment. And so I'm confident that's why Google flagged that account for the limited ad serving policy, is because understandably, they don't want people to be confused if you search for, you know, fill in the blank company, jobs there, and you see an ad. Google doesn't want people to think the ad is from that company if it's not actually from that company. Now, in our case, we're not doing anything in the ad copy to make people think that the ad is from that company. So, you know, we're not doing anything shady or that can be easily perceived as being confused by people seeing the ads. But anyhow, that's presumably why Google flagged that particular account. And in any account where you're targeting a lot of traffic that's, you know, brand names, keywords of other people that's not you, be aware that you're more likely to see this type of not suspension, but this type of flag in your account. Google gives some information about what they deem to be a qualified advertiser, so someone who would not be limited by this policy. So very, very vague and broad here what that means. You know, account attributes, what does that mean? Yeah, who knows? Ultimately, you know, kind of putting the reading between the lines, it's the longer the account has been running, the more history it has, the more compliant history it has, you know, it's not running into lots of problems over time, the more likely you are to be qualified. And then some industries are more likely to not have issues than others as well. Also, one easy thing you can do is make sure that your advertiser identity is verified in the Google Ads account, because that is one thing that Google looks at. it is, you know, we've already done that and done business operations verification for the Google Ads account in question. So it's not like that prevents you from having this error, or not error, well, error, but this type of flag. But those are helpful, you know, steps to take where you can. So what can you do to become a qualified advertiser? We just talked about that, and Google talks about that. And then how do you know it's been limited? So Google sent out, in this case, an email notification, and then they also put a red bar at the top of the Google Ads account saying that we're limited by the limited ad serving policy with a link to appeal. There's more information you can, you know, read on your own here that Google provides about what you can do to make sure that you're being clear, not accidentally misleading users so you see your ads, et cetera, et cetera. A lot of this is just kind of common sense stuff anyway. So at the root, you know, what impact does this have on an account? Well, I would say it's still somewhat early days with Google enforcing this, so there's still a lot of things that we are learning, but I can give you some examples from the particular Google Ads account in question here that was flagged about a week ago as of the recording of this video. And the short and long of it is we haven't really seen much of a negative impact in impressions yet. A couple days seemed a little bit down compared to kind of week over week and same day for, you know, couple weeks prior. But then we also have other days where impressions are actually up compared to week over week and months prior. So it seems like nothing is out of the ordinary yet, other than this normal variability of performance day in and day out. We'll see if that continues to be the case. Obviously, we're monitoring things closely. But in this particular instance, we've chosen not to appeal this flag yet because performance doesn't seem to be impacted. And frankly, if performance is not impacted, it's generally going to be safer to not, you know, create the potential of more problems by submitting appeals and digging deeper into things. So if you don't see impressions being significantly impacted, definitely, you know, consider the pros and cons of submitting an appeal. You may still want to. There may be nuances to your situation that make sense for you to go ahead and do it, but I wouldn't just say by default you have to go ahead and do it. Conversely, if you are seeing if you're seeing impression volume drop and it seems to correlate with the flag, then you may well want to appeal and try and get that fixed. And at the end of the day, I think it's going to be a case-by-case basis, and Google's still figuring out this policy, and so even my thoughts here will probably change over time as we see more and more examples of how Google enforces it, how they respond to appeals positively and negatively, and how this policy continues to impact Google Ads accounts. Stay tuned. We'll release more info as we get more info, and you can tap that subscribe button to make sure you get those in your feed here on YouTube. So until next time, this is John signing off.